My name is Dr. Marwa Kaisey. I'm a neurologist and MS specialist, and today we're going to talk about a new medication to treat MS. Now, new medications for MS come out all the time, so what makes this one special? One, it is a brand new type of medication, so it's not one of these copycat drugs that does basically the same thing as another drug we already have. And two, and this is huge, it is being studied in progressive forms of MS. So let's dive into it, but first, I have a little homework for you if you haven't done it already. You may want to go and watch my video on different subtypes of MS if you don't know what I mean by progressive types of MS. This therapeutic is based in the theory and the connection between Epstein-Barr virus, which is the virus that causes mono or the kissing disease, with MS. So I have a whole video on that, so go watch that too if you haven't so far. And then lastly, we're going to be using some basic immune system terminology, nothing too fancy, just B and T cells. So if you don't know what I'm talking about there, I have a very short review video on that too. So go and do your homework. I'll be right here when you get back. For those of you that already know all those things, or maybe have seen those videos, let's start talking about what this therapeutic is and why it's important. So the whole theory behind this therapeutic is that everybody with MS has been exposed to Epstein-Barr virus at some point in their life. Now, that doesn't make them too special because almost the entire population has been exposed to Epstein-Barr virus at some point in our lives. But literally, like almost 100% of people with MS have seen this virus, whether they had symptoms from it or not. And so there's a theory that this virus is part of what causes MS. Obviously, it's not the only thing that causes MS, otherwise most of the population would have MS, but it's part of it, right? So how is it a part of it? How does it drive the MS process? Well, one thought is that people with MS, their immune systems are not as good at clearing the cells that have been infected with Epstein-Barr, and that this virus and its effects can go and live in these cells for a very long time without ever being cleared from the body properly. The other kind of part of this is that as that person's immune system is trying to attack this, like stowaway, this Epstein-Barr virus, and attack the cells that are harboring it, it accidentally attacks innocent bystanders in the brain and the spinal cord that look like the cells that have this virus. This is a process called molecular mimicry. We see it in other forms of medical diseases and other autoimmune diseases specifically. And so the thought is that the immune system, one, just doesn't clear the Epstein-Barr virus infected cells very well to start with, or two, as it goes to clear these cells, it accidentally attacks other stuff that has nothing to do with these cells, but maybe looks enough like it to confuse the immune system, and that's what causes MS. And by other stuff, I'm referring to myelin, the stuff that is damaged when we have MS. And so the molecular mimicry aspect is very interesting. So if you think about this theory of how MS happens, what you would need is one, a medication that can go into the brain, which is actually not that common. Most medications don't. They stay in the blood. If you swallow a medication, you take it through IV, it doesn't typically penetrate into the brain. There's something called the blood-brain barrier. So you would need a medication that could cross the blood-brain barrier and that could then go and attack these nests of B cells that are harboring these Epstein-Barr virus cells and kill them off once and for all. So that's what you would need in a therapy, and that's the therapy that they designed. And the company that designed this is Atara Bio. I think it's A-T-A-R-A. I have no affiliation with them whatsoever. But they designed a medication that's currently known as ATA-188. So if you want to Google it, that's what you're looking for. There's no fancy drug name yet because they're in the very preliminary phases of testing it. But basically what they did is they designed a treatment that does exactly that. It crosses the blood-brain barrier and it goes and it destroys the B cells that are harboring the Epstein-Barr virus in the brain. They did this by taking blood samples from healthy individuals who had been exposed to Epstein-Barr virus, and they specifically took their T cells and they kind of packaged this up into an IV medication. It's infused over like 5 to 10 minutes, I think is very fast. And they have studied it in very small groups so far. So like I said, I have no affiliation with this company. The data I'm going to share with you is from stuff that they've presented at abstracts at conferences in the past, and most recently from a PowerPoint presentation that they gave to their investors. It's available online if you just Google this company and this medication name, or even if you just Google them in multiple sclerosis or Epstein-Barr. So this is all available online. And what they show are the results from their phase one study. So phase one studies, preliminary studies, very, very, very small, usually really only meant to evaluate safety, but they incorporated a phase two kind of dose finding aspect to it too. So this is a phase one, phase two combo study that they did. And when I'm talking tiny, I'm talking like 24 patients. So they had six groups, and these are all people with MS, people with progressive MS specifically. And they divided them, four groups of six people each. And these four groups differed in the dose that they got. So they're trying to find the ideal dose. And they gave them all these doses and they followed them for a year. That was like the main part of the study. And then they extended the study for another 4 years and randomized people to get maybe an extra dose every year and really tried to follow them longer, because 12 months is not long enough for a full MS study. So you want to see how these people progress over time. So I'll give you the month 12 results, because like I mentioned, that was kind of the main part of the study, even though that's not usually long enough to see true big progression in MS or true improvement or sustained improvement. So 20 out of the 24 people finished to that 1 year. And out of those 20, four got worse, 13 were stable, and seven improved. So again, with such a short time period, you would expect most people to be in the stable category, which is what they found. But the fact that seven people got better is very unusual. You would usually expect less than 10% of people with progressive MS to have any sort of improvement over a year time. And the seven people that got better, they followed those for an average of 3 years, and I'm sorry, up to 3 years. And of those, six out of the seven actually maintained that improvement. So they didn't backslide after this was done. So very interesting. Again, this was really done to kind of look at safety, but you're already starting to see a little bit of a signal that maybe this works, and maybe it at least stops progression, and maybe it even improves the functionality of people living with progressive MS, which would be a game changer for progressive MS. We barely have anything that can even kind of claim to slow it down. We have nothing that can claim to stop it entirely, and we definitely don't have anything that can claim to reverse the damage that's already been done. So again, this would be a huge game changer. The theory as to how this improvement was brought about is they did some dedicated MRI studies and looked at the tracts in the brain and saw that maybe there's some remyelination going on. So that's the theory as to how these people managed to improve with regards to their MS. So again, tiny study, didn't follow people for really long enough in the main study. So the next step that they're planning is a true phase two study. And the name of that is EMBOLD, E-M-B-O-L-D. And from what they've shared, they're going to enroll 80 people, 40 into the placebo and 40 into the drug arm. And then after a year, everybody gets the drug. So even if you end up in the placebo, you will eventually get treatment if you're in the study. And that they're planning then a bigger, would have to be much bigger, phase three study to validate this medication and really prove that it works in progressive MS. And then they have less specific plans about studying this in the future, but they do have plans to potentially study it in relapsing MS and more inflammatory types of disease. And honestly, most people like to focus on this part of the disease because that's where the money is, that's where most patients are, right? So that's part of, unfortunately, why we have few treatments for progressive MS, because it's less common than relapsing MS. So this has been a summary of ATA188, a new T-cell-based therapeutic using the fact that people with MS have all been exposed to Epstein-Barr virus, and using T-cells to get into the brain and kill off any lingering Epstein-Barr virus-infected cells in the nervous system, potentially even reversing the damage that MS has caused and allowing people to heal from progressive MS. So to be determined if this pans out. It's very, very early days yet, but it's very heartening to see people taking an interest in progressive forms of MS and treatments, and also taking a different approach than has been taken in the past, because we desperately need something new. I hope you learned something. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to share with other people who you think might be interested in this kind of research, and please subscribe to this channel so that you can be aware when new videos come up. Thanks, guys.